Hello, and thank you for joining me for this time of prayer. I'm so glad you've decided to come and spend some time with the Lord and reach our hearts closer to the throne of God. Let's light our candle. Candles. Our candles represent the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God who is our Papa, God who is Jesus, our Savior, and God who is Holy Spirit, who chooses to live and dwell in us, teach us, comfort us, show us the way, guide us, empower us, make us like Jesus. I'm going to start with Psalm 27, parts of Psalm 27. And I just invite you as I read this, I'm going to read it twice, just slowly. The first time I read it, I invite you to listen and ask the Lord if there's a phrase or a word that He would like to highlight to you this morning. Psalm 27, beginning with verse 4. Here's the one thing I crave from God. The one thing I seek above all else. I want the privilege of living with Him every moment in His house, finding the sweet loveliness of His face, filled with awe, delighting in His glory and grace. I want to live my life so close to Him that He takes pleasure in my every prayer. He has smuggled me into His secret place where I'm kept safe and secure, out of reach from all of my enemies. Lord, when You said to me, "Seek my face," my inner being responded, "I'm seeking Your face with all of my heart." Now teach me all about Your ways and tell me what to do. Make it clear for me to understand. Such a beautiful psalm of David, crying out for his Papa, God, for direction, for just a closeness and an abiding in His presence that there's nothing that can match that when you can truly abide in His presence and feel all of the strength and the comfort and the power that you need for your day. I'm going to read it one more time, and as I do, just ask the Lord, is there a call to action for you? Because I believe that every time we hear from the Lord, there's a number of components, but one of them is a call to action. God, what are You calling me to do as a result of Your word? Again, Psalm 27, beginning with verse 4, and I'm skipping several verses here. Here's the one thing I crave from God, the one thing I seek above all else. I want the privilege of living with Him every moment in His house, finding the sweet loveliness of His face, filled with awe, delighting in His glory and grace. I want to live my life so close to Him that He takes pleasure in my every prayer. He has smuggled me into His secret place where I'm kept safe and secure, out of reach from all of my enemies. Triumphant now, I'll bring Him my offerings of praise, singing and shouting with ecstatic joy. Lord, when You said to me, "Seek my face," my inner being responded, "Lord, I'm seeking Your face with all of my heart." Now teach me all about Your ways and tell me what to do. Make it clear for me to understand. Papa God, we come in the name of Jesus, empowered by Your Holy Spirit, praying that You would reveal to us the throne room, that You would allow us to see us seated in heavenly places, as You said we are. We are dual citizens living here on earth, but residing in heavenly places. Help us to feel your pleasure, God, your love for us, that you created us because you wanted us, that we are valuable and precious in your sight. God, help us to seek you with all of our hearts, with every cell of our beings. Help us to seek you. I'm going to play a love song to Jesus for us to worship to. It's a kind of an older song by Phillips Craig and Dean. It's called Pour My Love on You, and it's about pouring our love on Jesus. So just invite you to worship with this song. I do not own the copyrights to this song. Imagine yourself at the feet of Jesus, pouring out your love, oil and wine on him in worship. Enjoy that song again. Just tell your device to play Pour My Love on You by Phillips Craig and Dean. We're going to come into a time of prayer now where I'm going to be praying for this various groups of people that maybe are in my life or your life that you'd like to lift in prayer. So as I pray, you can simply speak their names out loud, bring them to your heart, allow the Lord to bless them as you lift their names before Him. First, we're going to pray for people who you may know that need to know the love of Jesus, who maybe are living in fear or living in self-rejection or don't understand their precious worth, and they maybe have rejected God either consciously or subconsciously because they didn't know how much they were loved. John 6:44 says that no one can come to the Father unless the Father draws them. And so we ask God right now that you would draw the people that we're speaking out, speaking their names, you would draw them to your heart, that you would help them to come to know you personally, that you would do anything that you need to do, fair or unfair, to bring them to your throne, that you would visit them in the night, that you would give them visions and dreams, you would capture their imagination, that you would show up in strange and surprising places, that you would interrupt and intersect them, that you would cause them to have an encounter with you that would bring them to the amazing love that you have for them. So God, we lift up all these people before you, asking for you to draw them to yourself. All of us know people who need guidance and direction in their lives for decisions or just to know what you want from us next, God. And I love this passage in Jeremiah 6:16. It says, "This is what the Lord says, stand at the crossroads and ask and look. Stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient paths. Ask where the good way is and walk in it, and you will find rest for your souls." So God, there are people in our lives who need direction and guidance. They need to know where the good path is. So God, we lift these names before you now, people we know who need that direction. And we ask that you would bring them to that crossroads and you would help them to stand and look and ask you where the good way is. And then when they hear your direction, it could be something subtle that they hear your voice. Sometimes your voice comes so still and small. Sometimes your voice comes through a passage of scripture, a friend. It can come in so many different ways. But help them to hear the good path and then to walk in it, knowing that they are walking with you and that they will find rest for their souls. We all know people who are in harm's way today, either from service in our own armed forces. As we know, the National Guard is out now. Also, those who are in the medical field really are in the front lines of a war as well. So we want to bring those names before you, Lord, that we want to lift and ask for your protection. In Psalm 34:7, it says, "The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, who hold him in high respect, and he delivers them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him." I love that image of God encamping around us. So as you imagine that person or people in your lives who are facing danger from different sources, in your mind's eye, imagine the Lord, the armies of the Lord, the angelic armies in their full battle gear encamping around your loved ones, that while they may not be seen in the natural, they are truly real. In Hebrews, it says that angels are servants sent to serve those who will inherit salvation. And so we know that they are ministers from God, sent to protect and guide, send messages to empower, to heal. So many things that angels can do for us. So we invite that angelic realm into the lives of those who need your protection, and as well, ourselves as well. Today, I'd also like to pray for those in authority around us. We know that Romans 13 is very specific, that we are to pray for those in authority over us, our pastors, our leaders, our state, local, and national government, and those over us in the workplace who are our supervisors, those who oversee us, And so we do, Lord, as we lift out those names before you, people that we know in our lives who are over us, we give them to you. We ask that you would become a voice, a strong voice in their ear, that when they would seek direction, that they may not even know who you are, but you've shown yourself to be able to influence leaders who don't even know you. We see that all throughout biblical record, that you can influence leaders who don't even know you. You can turn their heads. So we ask you for every leader in our lives, bless them, give them direction and guidance, help them to know the good path and help them to walk in it. Help us to not be in rebellion over any authority over us. 1 Samuel 15 says that rebellion is very similar to witchcraft. I don't think any of us want to dabble in that. So we bring blessing to all those in authority over us. Many of us know people who are suffering from grief right now, grief of a loss of a loved one or a loss of hope or just a loss of a sense of purpose over this inactivity we've been experiencing. Psalm 10:14 says, "But you, God, see the trouble of the afflicted. You consider the grief and you take it in hand. The victims can commit themselves to you. You are the helper of the fatherless." So Lord, for every person we're mentioning before you right now who is suffering from grief of any kind, we ask you to hold their heart in your hand, that you would embrace them, that you would allow them to come into your presence and receive all that they need from you, strength and comfort, and a knowing that our grief is temporary, that it has its course, and that as we remain in your presence during that time, you will bring us to the other side and bring us to a place of joy once again. God, there are often people in our lives who offend us and who hurt us, who've rejected us, abused us, slandered our names. And the human, sinful side wants to hold grudges and hold on to unforgiveness and become bitter because we feel it's our right. But God, you tell us in Matthew 6:15, you say, if we do not forgive others their sins, that Father God will not forgive us our sins. Now, we don't really like that verse so much because we want to be forgiven, although we are not so sure about the people who hurt us. But God, we believe in your word. And so I ask every person here, including myself, to listen for the names that we need to release in forgiveness, not because they deserve it, but because we're doing it out of obedience, knowing that, Father God, you are the true judge. And when we forgive, we are the ones who are set free. So God, I'm going to give a moment for us to listen for names we need to release in forgiveness. God, we freely and fully forgive each one of these people out of obedience to your word, knowing that you are the true judge and we are not. We thank you that as we release those people, that you are then free to forgive us of the errors that we make as well. Finally, I want to pray for people who need physical healing in their bodies. Jesus went everywhere and touched and healed people. You can't turn a page in the gospel without stumbling over many, many healings. It was one of Jesus' primary purposes on the earth was to heal people, to bring them to an understanding of who he was. And so God is still healing today to help people know who he is, because where there is power, there is truth. And we believe that Jesus is the one true, the one way, the one truth. And so we look at in Matthew 8, there was a leper that came to Jesus for healing, and the leper said to Jesus, if you're willing, I can be made clean. And Jesus said, I am willing. In other words, there's never a time when God doesn't want to heal and restore. So God, we lift up those who right now will speak out their names, those who need a healing touch from you. We ask that you would be the ones who would bring them restoration, bring them truth, bring them love, bring their bodies into complete harmony with your will, which is wholeness and wellness. We command their bodies to receive the healing power from the Holy Spirit. We tell all pain to go, all affliction to go. We tell the body to come into alignment with the perfect will of God. As we conclude our time together, let's pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the glory, and the power, forever. I'd love to pray also the Wesley Covenant Prayer, and I'd like to pray it in a repeat after me mode. So please repeat after me. I am no longer my own, but yours. Put me to what you will. Place me with whom you will. Put me to doing, put me to suffering. Let me be put to work for you, or set aside for you. Praised for you, or criticized for you. Let me be full, let me be empty. Let me have all things. Let me have nothing. I freely and fully surrender all things to your glory and service. And now, O wonderful and holy God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, you are mine and I am yours. So be it. And the covenant with which I have made on earth, let it also be made in heaven. Amen. One thing I love to do is to pray with people, either in person or over the phone. Right now we're doing more phone, but I would love to pray with you if you have a physical need for healing or any kind of emotional healing, something that's been on your heart and you need God's touch. I would love to pray with you over the phone, and soon we'll be doing it in person in the prayer room, I'm hoping. And you can contact me with this phone number or email. You can call me, text me, or email me, and we'll set up a time for me to pray with you. It would be my greatest honor. I love you all. God bless you. In Jesus' name, go now in the power of the Holy Spirit as he calls you into the world.